Adenosine triphosphate, or ATP, is the energy source in living cells. Energy is generated by the splitting of one of three phosphate groups. This energy is used by proteins, which carry out different tasks like building important compounds, sending signals, and helping cells move and divide. Although these different jobs require a lot of energy, it turns out there is about 100 times more ATP in a cell than it needs for energy. Making ATP is costly, so why would cells make so much more of this valuable molecule? We discovered a second energy-independent role for ATP in keeping the inside of a cell functional. It turns out that the inside of a cell is not as spacious as it looks in textbook diagrams. It's actually really crowded with proteins. But if we try to crowd that much protein into a test tube, the proteins would all stick together in a big clump. So, cells must have specific ways to prevent proteins from clumping together. We found that in a test tube, ATP can do this. When we add it, the proteins stay separate from each other. But how? The chemical structure of ATP resembles that of a hydrotrope. Hydrotropes can prevent molecules from clumping together. One example we use comes from everyday life, the boiled egg. When boiling an egg, the proteins in the clear egg white clump together, giving it a white color. If we add ATP, we can delay or even prevent clumping of the egg protein and the egg white stays clear. In our work, we show that ATP acts as a biological hydrotrope and it can only do so in large amounts, like we see in cells. So maybe during evolution the first role of ATP was to keep things from clumping together, and since there was so much of it around, it was later adopted as the important source of energy we know it as today. To find out more, please check out our paper in Science.